First of all, I'd like to thank you for this kind invitation. It is a great honor to me to be here with you.
We have 18 patients with hepatitis B virus DNA. Only 4 of them was hepatitis B core immunoglobulin G positive, and one of them was hepatitis B core immunoglobulin positive. From the 19 patients who were hepatitis B core immunoglobulin G positive, only 15% of them core positive, and 4 of them hepatitis B virus DNA positive. We found that the genotype of hepatitis B virus in patients under hemodialysis were mainly 14.4%, followed by A 27.8%, Zin B 22.2%, while health control only two genotypes were detected, C 15% and mixed type, BRF type 15%. The risk factor for local hepatitis B virus in patient under hemodialysis significant association between duration and the number of blood to urine transfusion. What is the local hepatitis B virus? Hepatitis B virus DNA detection in serum or in the liver by sensitive diagnostic test in hepatitis B is antigen negative patient with or without serological marker of previous viral infection. The first term of occult B was by Tabor et al. In 1979, who was found the occult B post transfusion hepatitis and post blood transfusion. This was the major cause for transmission of occult B infection. It was found that occult B infection prevalence seemed to be higher among subjects at higher risk for hepatitis B infection and with liver disease. Occult B infection is the major cause of post-transfusion hepatitis B in Western country and in countries like India and Taiwan with higher risk of transmission than for HCV and HIV. Hepatocyte is a reservoir for hepatitis B virus. Hepatitis B after orthotopic liver transplantation with occult B infection in donor is a well-known cause of de novo hepatitis in hepatitis B negative recipient. Very low rate occurrence in cases of kidney, heart, and bone marrow transplant. Hepatitis B is antigen negative, either we have seropositive patient or seronegative patient. Hepatitis B virus DNA is the only marker of the infection. Hepatitis B DNA in the serum less than 200 international per minute. But we have a problem here if we have an S mutant type of hepatitis B virus. And this is types of hepatitis B. We can't detect it by the present PCR, and we discover it with hepatitis B DNA. When we search for hepatitis B antigen and hepatitis B antibody, we didn't find it, but with PCR, we can find it. Occult hepatitis B patient on hemodialysis has ranged from 0% to 20%. SSK mutant infection, hepatitis B virus strain, SK mutation pre-serum, which is not recognized by commercially available kits, even when most sensitive ones are used. False occult B infection has been detected in up to 40% of patients with occult B. This is the occult B virus, hepatitis B is antigen negative, hepatitis B E antigen negative, hepatitis B virus DNA positive, anti-hepatitis B core immunoglobulin M negative, but we can have with him hepatitis B core immunoglobulin G positive, hepatitis B E anti-hepatitis B E negative, and even anti-hepatitis B S antibody, hepatitis B S antibody positive, and the patient still have hepatitis B viral DNA. A requirement for admission to dialysis unit, hepatitis B S antigen, hepatitis B core antibody, hepatitis B S antibody, HCV and HIV status. Monthly monitoring of ACT and ALT, hepatitis B S antigen, and annual monitoring for hepatitis B S antibody and hepatitis C virus. What is the complication of occult B? Reactivation of the infection, development of hepatitis B virus related liver disease, transmission of occult virus mainly through blood transfusion and organ transplantation. All patients receiving chemotherapy and immunotherapy must be treated if they have occult B. A patient with anti-hepatitis B core antibody positive must have treatment. If ALT elevation present, if hepatitis B virus reactivation is present. I don't know if there is a recommendation from our society in Egypt to do hepatitis B virus DNA for our patients or not. But in our department, we don't do it.
Any short questions? lecture. I want to ask why you are not doing hepatitis C, E antigen, and D antibody. Can we help you to narrow the spectrum to detect cases of hepatitis B, S, C, mutant lesions?
We first of all, we search for OCT. And if OCT, hepatitis B, E antigen, and that both will be negative. Only, the only positive OCT is hepatitis B virus DNA. Also, hepatitis B virus DNA may be associated with all the markers are negative. And in spite of that, we found 18 patients, our patients, among the 96 patients, we found 18 patients positive with hepatitis B virus DNA. And I still have a question for you. Treat or not? Screen or not? Isolate or not?
Okay, I differ with you in a point that all patients with hepatitis B, S, E, are hepatitis B, E, antigen, the antibody are negative. I don't agree on this. Because you know very well that the S, E, mutant, this is regarding the surface antigen, while the E, the envelope, which is a part different from this story. So again, some cases, I know that, not all cases, but you will narrow the spectrum of detection of some various cases of hepatitis B virus. You can detect it if you make the full spectrum involving the hepatitis B antigen and D antibody. This will help you. Okay.
Can I answer?
Joanna?
Can I
start
in
the house?
No, how
you are the next speaker. How can I measure it? So I have to concentrate on that. Now I probably to introduce my colleague, Professor Dr. Ahmed Adam, is talking about a very debatable but applicable in Egypt, which is the economic of HDF therapy once a week. Is it good or bad thing?
Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman. It is, I'm actually am I honored and delighted that I will be here. And